Very rarely do I come across new tools that change my editing so much that I just have to do a review about it. And then even more rare do I have to do a second review to tell you just how incredible it actually is. And no, it's not a new computer, it's not a new monitor, it's not a new color correction tool, it's not a new plugin, it's literally a mouse. Hello, my friends. I hope you're doing well. Today, I want to talk all about the Logitech MX Master Mouse. This thing is incredible. And I know you're thinking to yourself, it's just a mouse. I have a mouse already and I don't ever use it. I prefer my trackpad. But I promise you, you've probably never used a mouse quite like this. And if you do have this mouse and you've been using it, you're thinking to yourself, it's not that special. It's probably because you haven't customized it enough to make it work for the applications that you're actually using it for. So I wanted to take this time to simply go through my setup of how I use this mouse with Final Cut Pro specifically for editing. So there are a lot of buttons on this mouse. You obviously have your left click button, your right click button. That's just the standard that any mouse would have. But then on top of that, you have a lot of other buttons. You have a button on the top here. You have another button on the scroll wheel itself that actually is a button. So it does scroll like a normal mouse would, but it actually presses down and has another button for that. It also has buttons here on your thumb, and it has buttons inside of here on the inside of your thumb when you're rolling. So you have a button here, a scroll wheel that's a vertical scroll wheel, and this is the horizontal scroll wheel, scroll wheel this way, scroll wheel this way, button, 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 a lot of buttons. Now buttons are great, but if you can't customize everyone to do exactly what you want, they're not so great. This Logitech mouse allows you to not only control what the buttons do, but you can change what they do on a per application basis. So what's incredible about that is that in real time, I can have these buttons do different things depending on what application I'm actually in. So if I bounce simply from, let's just say, from Final Cut Pro editing into my mail program or into Google Chrome or into Lightroom, whatever it is, I can route these buttons differently for every single program, which is incredible. The reason that I love how customizable this mouse is because I edit most efficiently when I can keep my hands in the same position as often as possible. With this mouse, I want to do all I can of eliminating the need for my hand to go over to hit tools that I always hit on my keyboard. So I've routed a lot of the buttons to hit a lot of the buttons on the right side of the keyboard that do unique things for me. So first off, this button right here, when I am scrolling through my timeline and I just choose any clip whatsoever, whatever it is, if I push in the actual scroll wheel, it will simply delete the clip that I'm over top of, which is very convenient because instead of having to take my hand off the mouse and hit the delete key, I simply can click the actual scroll wheel and it works amazing. Next thing is this little button right here in the center, this little square button. I have that to be my blade tool. So I simply can hover over any clip wherever I'm at and push that button and it will put a blade directly where my playhead is on any clip that I'm currently hovering over that is selected. That is extremely useful because I do that constantly, being able to just quickly blade something and remove it or however I want to blade it. It's really nice to be able to just blade it. And then because this is my delete key, I can select, and I can delete all from the click of my mouse. The next button is this button on the side here, the one that's actually laying on the mouse in general. This is actually what I have routed as my left bracket. Now my left bracket, if you didn't watch my other shortcuts tutorial video all about my favorite shortcuts for Final Cut Pro, I will put a card here below. You can watch that and learn more about what shortcuts I'm talking about. But I have this as my trim start tool. Now what that allows me to do is at any given point in my edit, and I want to simply go from a certain spot and I want to just blade that. Instead of having to blade it and then delete that spot out, I can just simply trim to start and it will cut from that clip right to where the playhead is. So if you don't know about that actual shortcut, you're missing a lot. I suggest watching my other video all about that. But that's what I have the button as. Now where it becomes even more useful, and some of this is in Final Cut, is when I press Shift and I press that button on my thumb, it will actually trim the end. So while I'm hovering over, if I decide to trim the start point right there, but then I hover to this area over here and I want to trim the end point, I hold shift and press that same button and it jumps trim end, and the other one is trim start. So the same mouse button. So when I'm moving around here, I can trim the start, I can trim the end, I can blade it here, I can choose that, delete that. I can do whatever I want all with the mouse. Instead of having to do bracket tool and take my mouse off, right bracket tool, take my mouse off, blade tool, take my hand off the mouse, delete tool. Instead of doing all those buttons, it's all done with my actual mouse. So the buttons on the inside here, these ones inside your left thumb wheel, there's two buttons here. I have them routed to switch back and forth between projects. So a lot of times when I'm editing a project and I have multiple projects or timelines open, I want to quickly bounce from one to what I was previously working on. And instead of having to go up to this little arrow right here and click it and go back to that timeline, and then you click the right arrow and go back to it. So the way I have them routed, and I'll show you how I actually have it routed in Final Cut, but when I press the shift key and the one button underneath, it will jump from one timeline to the previous timeline. And when I hit shift and the top button, it will jump back. So if I'm cruising through my editing here and I want to grab something from another timeline, let's say I'm grabbing stuff from a ceremony of a wedding and I want to bring it into the feature film, I can simply hit shift, press with my thumb, I jump back and forth, I copy a bunch of stuff from this timeline, I hit shift again, press the other button, I jump right back, and I hit paste and I'm flying between it. Instead of having to go up to the arrows, go here, then I go here, select the thing, copy, and I go over this other arrow, I just fly through it. And it saves me a lot of time bouncing through those. So let's jump right into the computer so I can show you how we actually get that all routed. So we're jumping right in here to the Logitech Options app. This is an app you just download from Logitech's website and allows you to customize all the buttons on the mouse to do whatever you want. So make sure you go and download this right away because this is required to be able to do whatever you want it to do. Now the unique thing here is that, like I said, you can change it and actually change what each button does on a per application basis, which is incredible. So go ahead and if you don't already have Final Cut in there, just go to Add Application, find Final Cut here, choose it. Make sure that when you're doing your customized buttons like I'm setting up right now that you are in Final Cut, not just all applications, because what you may route for Final Cut may really not be what you want to route for other things depending on what keys you make them for. Now the cool thing about the way you can customize these is that you can make them be any specific key. So as you see here, this is Command B, this is Delete, this is left bracket, this is horizontal scrolling, this is Enter, this is Delete as well. Now the reason this is Delete as well, I'll explain in a second, but let's just jump right into how we do things. So the important thing, if you want to actually set up things exactly how I just explained them, you have to also set these up accordingly in Final Cut. So for example, if I choose Command B as my keystroke assignment, I have to make sure that Command B in Final Cut does what I think it's going to do. So when you go to Final Cut Pro Commands, Customize, this is where you customize your actual keyboard shortcuts. So if I look at Command B, for example, you can see right here, Command B is blade. So then I'm telling the mouse in Logitech Options that I want this button to be Command B. The way that I would do that is if, let's just say it was at something else as the default right now, you'd go ahead and click that, and you go right here to where it says keystroke assignment. You click that, and you simply type in your keystroke, and it will just make it what you say. So when I go to anything here inside of Final Cut, and I hover over any specific area and I press that button, it does Command B and you see that it blades that right there. Okay, the next button up here is Delete. That is just simply your delete key. Just go to keyboard assignment and hit the delete key and make it. And then that way when I go to any clip in Final Cut, I just press delete and it removes it just like the delete key would do in general. That one's simple. This is set up as the left bracket. Now inside Final Cut, I have the left bracket. If we go into my customized shortcuts here, left bracket is currently set at trim start. And then right bracket is set at trim end. Now the uniqueness of how I have it set up with my shift key making it be the opposite of what it does by default is that even though in the Logitech options here, you see that I have this as left bracket. Left bracket, obviously, in Final Cut is designed to trim start. Now, shift left bracket, as you see, is designated as trim end. So even though trim end is also on the right bracket, the reason I have shift left bracket be trim end is because then if I'm in Final Cut, if I press this little button on the inside of my thumb, it'll trim the start, you can see there. And then if I hold shift, it'll trim the end with that same button instead of start. So as you can see, it allows me to just keep my finger on the mouse and just hold down shift to do the end bracket instead of the left. So it's left bracket and right bracket within the same key. Then over here, this is horizontal scrolling. Then I have this as the enter button. The enter button, the reason that I have it as the enter button is that number one, if I just press it at any given point here, if I press that little end button, the enter button will jump all the way back to the beginning. So regardless of where I'm at inside my timeline here, if I press that button, it will jump right back just like the enter key on my keyboard would. To make sure that that happens, you simply go into your keyboard shortcuts, you make the keyboard return button go to beginning. Then what I have on that same enter, you can see that shift enter is designed for timeline history forward. So if I'm back here, if I go to another clip, timeline here, you can see that this right here, this is timeline history forward. So it jumps to the next timeline. So I have that set up here as shift enter. So if I hit shift on my keyboard and I press the mouse button, it shifts to the next timeline. And then I have the one right underneath it, this button right here, as delete. Now the reason I have it as delete, inside of Final Cut here, if I hit shift delete, you can see here on the delete key, shift delete is timeline history back. So that allows me to just have these two buttons right next to one another. Back goes timeline back, shift up goes timeline forward, all with that little, those two buttons right next to each other on the actual wheel. So yes, it may seem pretty complicated how I have that whole thing set up and maybe even confusing to you. And you may be thinking to yourself, that just seems like a lot of work and more than I'd even remember. But it literally has changed how fast I edit incredibly. And I'm already a very fast editor. I always feel like I know shortcuts very, very well. But this mouse has made editing so much more enjoyable and fast that I've actually found it very hard to use a trackpad anymore or any other mouse that doesn't have this customization because I'm so used to how unique and useful each little shortcut is specifically in the mouse. And that is something that I absolutely love about it. So if you're a person that's currently using like the Apple mouse or you're using any other mouse that doesn't have this type of customization, this is like the best $100 or something around there that you will probably ever spend. I do get a little bit of commission if you click the affiliate link in this actual description to buy it through Amazon. I do get a little piece of that, which I greatly appreciate. This is not a sponsor video at all. This is simply just me telling you about a mouse that has made my editing so much more enjoyable. It's super comfortable, easy to use, and I absolutely love it. But that's going to do it for this video. Probably a pretty long video for just being a mouse, but I had to tell you about this tool because it's been amazing for me. So if you're new around here and you're still watching this, you are awesome. Consider subscribing. Leave a comment below. Tell me what you think. Tell me if this changed your whole philosophy as well. And once you get this mouse, I would love to hear some feedback in terms of what you think about it. So go ahead, click that link, buy it. It's worth it, I promise you. And if you don't like it at all, you can return it. But believe me, once you customize it, you won't return it.